Well, oil contamination is a major issue. And so the goal here would be to separate the oil from water. And we're doing it on a small scale, but we believe that can be scaled up so that on a larger scale, this technology can be applied. The work we have done in the lab, it shows that we are able to attract or repel liquids of interest very effectively. So there's really nothing which would pass through the sieve. For demonstration, we have taken a sieve, we have coated with the technology we have developed, and in one case, we put oil-water mixture, the oil get absorbed, and the water goes through. We are able to separate the two liquids very effectively. We think the approach we're using is rather straightforward. Okay, we have tried it in a variety of other applications, repelling water, repelling oils, repelling all kinds of organic fluids. We have tried over and over again by using various deposition techniques, and it works. And people are trying to scale it up in other applications where we are repelling water. You can buy roof tiles. You supposedly can buy fabrics which repel a variety of fluids. So given the fact that we understand in the lab, we can model it, people have tried it in other applications of similar technologies, there is a high level of confidence this technology should work. So what potentially one could do in oil-water separation, you could create a large fabric with a wire mesh with this coating, and this could filter out the oil rather easily, depending on size of the fabric you use and how you mechanize it. So we believe that it should be relatively simple to do that. So we started looking at lotus leaf, and we wanted to understand how nature provides the functionality based on our background. So we looked at the samples, we did the modeling, we understood how nature does it. Then from our understanding, we developed structures in the lab using nature's route. We used the materials nature uses and the processes we believe nature uses to create those surfaces. We verified the surfaces we had created in the lab have the functionality comparable to that of found in nature. Then by using smart materials and manufacturing processes, we started creating a variety of surfaces which can be used in commercial applications.